Good afternoon to one and all present here. I welcome you all for this virtual extramural series. So today we have Swarna Mugi of second year BSc CS to discuss about RPA, Robotic Process Automation. Over to you, Swarna Mugi.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, one and all present here. Good afternoon, one and all present here, who had gathered on this busy schedule. I'm Swarna Mugi and I'm coming from CS department to share few things which I know about RPA. Before starting the section, I sincerely thank our principal ma'am, dean ma'am, and all our staffs who arranged this section today. And my special thanks to my department HOD ma'am, Dr. A. Kokilavani ma'am, and all my department faculties who have given this opportunity to share my experiences and things what I know about RPA. So I start my section now. First, I'm going to talk about RPA. So first, what is mean by RPA? It is none other than robotic process automation. So what it means is a software technique that makes it easy to build, develop, and manage software robots that emulates human action interacting with digital systems and softwares. So RPA is one of the easy technique which all can use it if they know system practices and software things. If they know, they can use RPA. So we got an opportunity to learn RPA from our college. Our department have arranged one section called RPA classes, and we have even community for that in our college. So in that we have learned many things about RPA. So Pavitra ma'am have taught us many things about RPA in that section. Actually, in that specifically we came to know about UiPath, which is very easy to learn, and it was very good one too. How we can do a certain easy things in it, we came to know actually on that day. So now about UiPath, I'm gonna to say so that if anyone is interested, they can go and join in our college committee to RPA committee also. We can join, so that will be easy. Actually, it is nothing. It is just an thing which is we want to take. We have to install the UiPath in our systems, and we have to just drag and drop all those things which is there. That means whatever the codings we are needed, that can be just dragged and dropped using some features. We can drag and drop. This is our UiPath actually, which we use it in our daily sections. It is very easy, so that we can learn, we can make many things out of that. So in RPA, that this is UiPath is one of the biggest thing which we come to know. So UiPath is just opening in my presentation. Ma'am, net is somewhat slow, ma'am. 1 minute, ma'am. It just opens.
Okay, da, sure.
Yeah, this is the UiPath which we works. So in this we have many options. So first we will start with process. So we'll create some of the anything you can create. So I'm just taking a data table. I'm just taking it out now. So I have already created 1 and 2. So I have create 1 and another one data table. So I have created and 2.
So this is how it starts to run actually.
After it opens, we have a platform, so that in that we can cut, copy and paste the codings or the things, commands which we need in it. So I hope you all understand about the UiPath. so that I can go with RPA and its benefits and its other things of that. So RPA வந்து எதுக்கெல்லாம் யூஸ் ஆகுது அப்படிங்கறத just we I'll say it is actually a concluding of data entries it is used, and it is one of the best thing which a human cannot do also we can easily come and do it. அதாவது வந்து ஒரு திங் வந்து ரொம்ப டிஃபிகல்ட்டா ஒரு பர்சனுக்கு இருக்கு அப்படின்னா அதை விட வந்து அ சிஸ்டம் ஆர் அ கோடிங் கேன் டூ தட் ஈஸியர் அண்ட் ஈஸியர். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், இஃப் யூ ஹாவ் 500 எக்ஸல் ஷீட்ஸ் அண்ட் வி வாண்ட் டு கம்பைன் அண்ட் வி ஹாவ் டு பிக் எனி திங், மீன்ஸ் வி கேன் யூஸ் திஸ் யூஐ பாத் யூசிங் திஸ் ஓப்பன் மெயின் ஒர்க் ஃப்ளோ. ஐ ஜஸ்ட் கிளிக் ஆன் இட் ஸோ தட் ஐ வில் கெட் ஒன் ஆஃப் தி ஒர்க்கிங் ஸ்டேஷன் லைக் திஸ். ஸோ drop activity here, that's the thing which we use it. So if I click means options of everything will come over here so that I can just drag something which I need and I can just drop it and I can do the projects easily. Instead of taking it out of manual, it will be easier to do for us. So RPA is of three types. It is attended automation, unattended automation, and hybrid automation. So there are three types actually in it. So what are the benefits of UiPath is, so actually models on a maridha, it is easy to build or deploy a managed software, and it is easy to take away the details or the things which we need. So for that, RPA is one of the biggest thing. So RPA la vandu the main tool appadina we'll say that the UiPath. So best platform of RPA is UiPath, which is easy to work on the station. So UiPath appadina varumbodhu we have some tools in UiPath. So that tools are the tools are over here. So if we click on this activity drop here, we'll be getting many tools over here. So that if I need an Excel sheet, means I can select the Excel command over here and I can just drop it over here. So for everything we have over here, not only for Excel sheet, even for creating a robot also we have over here. The commands will be there. Just you can drop it over there. That's it. It will be very easy. And everyone can easily use this if they know the basics and codings of computer science and technologies, etc. So it will be easy to do it, actually. So next is the benefit and means of what is the career in RPA? Because if you study RPA, what is the use? Some of them will ask me actually. Yeah, the padichu what you are going to do, they'll ask. By that time, I can easily say the benefits or the career what I have in it. So the career is nothing but first, what is the qualification is one of the degree in computer science you could have. And the basics of algorithms you should know first of all. And the you know to know how to generate a code in it actually. So eppadi vandu or code vandu pannanum appingiradhu you have to come to know, so that only you can use this RPA or the RPA UiPath platform or anything in it. So that is the main thing. How the base of RPA is only three things, that is your completion of degree you want, and you have to know the algorithms. And the third thing, you have to know the coding languages. It can be anything, but somewhat you have to know about the coding languages. So only it will be very easy to come through it. But RPA is one of the biggest and which is there in the demand of nowadays is only the RPA, which you can come and do easier and you can earn easier. In the basic stage, I'm not going to talk about the exceptional stages. I'm just saying about the first stage, the beginning stage. We can easily learn and we can easily do some of the projects and some of the things we need in the main part. or somewhat the easier tasks, we can do it. So the main career of RPA is nothing but it is very effective, more than the person do that. And it is lowering our burden so that we can control our works with a computer means you can just activate the system for that, right? So that it is very, very useful. And nowadays in software companies, they are just asking, do you know about RPA? Do you have studied RPA? Or you know how to work in RPA? They used to ask because the salary which is given to a person is the half of that you have used in RPAs and your past studios, because it is very easy and it is very, very comfort zone for us. So RPA vandu padikkanum appdi nenachinga, you can, everyone can just study RPA. And in RPA you can create apps, robots, any of the developing things you can share it in RPA and can do it in RPA actually. So RPA comes under actually what is AI. AI oda interact aida vandu RPA is coming. How it comes means AI is one of the AI is one of the important thing, and sharing through that it just comes from it. So RPA was invented when it seems as it was actually invented in 2003 actually. First was they have found RPA. So RPA was found in 2003 actually. So importance also I have told you. So it is cost wise also it is very funful and easy to activate. This is controlled by persons who knows the codings and etc. So mom, can we do one project like mom now?
How long it will prolong the
Just 5 to 5 or 10
yeah,
minutes,
you
mom.
can proceed.
Thank you, mom. So we have done already. I have done one. I'm just going to do that again. I'm just opening it out. I'm just doing a new iPad, which is easy to understand and easy to do. You can also, everyone can do that. So I'm taking this. So I have just dragged the codes from over here. If we want, again, I'll just do it. How it comes, I'll just show. So I'm just clicking on the add button and I'm just typing what the name I have to give. So minus input dialog box. So I'm just clicking over that. I'm just clicking it out and taking it out. So that's all, I just do it. Yeah, just it came right out over here. So just I have dragged it and I have dropped it down. Actually, it comes over here. I already have done it. We don't have time, so just doing it again. I'm just showing it out. So we have to instruct what the things we need. So in this area, we have the, in this side, the project panel over here. This is the main screen which we works on it. So if I comes over this right side, I have a property panel over here, which we can see. So that whatever the things I have to label over here will be labeled over here also. And the instructions, if I need anything, I'll just label it over here. This is called as property panel. So I'll just drop it over here. So dialog title, I'm just giving it as switch. Being it as a string, so I'm giving in double quotes now. It's being a string value, I'm just giving it as in it double quotes. So next is
I'm going to label the input input. So after labeling the input value, I will just, this would come over here. After that, if you see, I have filled everything over here. Enter your favorite color. So I have given it as favorite color. So favorite color I have given. I'll just open and show you what I have done next. So here, if you see, enter your favorite color I have given. So after that, the text, it is actually a text box. If it is a single text box, you can give like this. If it is not a single text box, you can change it as multiple choice also. So I have just given all those things. If I just give debug and run, the option could start to run over here now, actually. So this is what how we use the RPA easier and more easier. So I have just given run. So it's running it out actually. Yeah, it have been run and it's just, I got the answer and just it comes. See, I have got the answer. So if I enter red, it shows the number 1. If I enter blue, or if I enter 2, it shows me blue or 2. If I have entered the non-values, which I am not given over here. For example, if I give pink, it won't give any input. If you see, it won't give any input because I have not given any value which is substant to the value that has pink. So whatever you give in UiPath or the instructions which you have given in UiPath, it just automatically comes to you easier and more easier. So okay, the next thing I'm going to say is about, so yeah, so there are many tools. Already said you, we have many tools in UiPath. First itself I have said. So these are the main things. And even we can browse, or even we can do activities which are related to Chrome or any other field such as Firefox, Java, anything you can use in it. So before using, you have to go to your tool set, tools, and select over Chrome. And if you give OK, it will able in your, I have already abled, so it won't come for me, sorry. So if you give able, we can even do, or we can even work on the Chrome or any of the websites which we need also. So this is a start. If you give start, the main panel will just come. Tools, these are the tools which we have in UiPath. Next is our templates. We have many templates to work, not only this. So for robotics, which panel we use is this one. So we'll use this one only for creating robots. I'll just, yeah. We have many panels in UiPath for which we want to take. For that, we can take that suitable one, which is very easier. We can also do in your normal start process platform also, but mainly for this one will be easier more than that. Everything will be there. Just you can easily, you don't want to search also, just it comes easier. It's loading actually for me. It's it's loading, so only I just came to this main slide itself. So the next thing is, I'll just show how to take do a robot in, or a robot activation in UiPath now. So this is my main screen. Actually it is loading because I have used many to do already. Last week we were having some projects and also we were doing many things. it comes somewhat slowly. So it's loading. Let it load it. So features of UiPath is, some of the features I'll just say in UiPath. So main feature is drag and drop flow is there in our UiPath. Drag and drop is there. Visual processing step. Visually we can process the steps. Next is graphical workspace is also there in it. And you can record a whole program or a whole code before you are doing it, easier and easier. And advanced scrapping option is also there in the UiPath, which we can easily scrap the data or the scrap the main files which we need. So this is how my robotic starting point comes. I'll just start that. I have given. So this is how it shows first for us if you open the UiPath robotic side. If you open, it shows like this only for the first time. So we have to just give the instructions in all those. So which will be here. So you have to drag and drop all the things which you want, and you can perform a task or perform a robot easier and easier. More than you are writing a code in Java or writing a code in any of the other platforms of languages. So this could be easy. If there is any debug in other platforms, it is somewhat difficult to correct it, right? But in this, it is very easy because it just itself maximum correct all the debugs. When we give as debug, I'll just choose the debug file. If I choose what and all debugs I have, it automatically just show me the debugs which I have in it. So that is one of the main and good thing which we can do it actually. So next is high security. Security is there in this UiPath. For example, sometimes we have even passwords for this. If it is very important code or if it is an important project, it can be secured very safely in our path and it won't change too. It will not change or it will not happen anything for that. So one of the secured path is UiPath. So that is one of the main features. So if we study RPA, means it is one of the biggest and the most upcoming future user or the future thing which we comes to know and which we can do it easily. So my request is only one thing, that as all the students have to join in our KG College UiPath, sorry, KG College RPA community, so that we have many things to learn in it. Actually, many and many things we have in our community also. So if students are willing, they can come and join in RPA committee when you are interested. And if you are willing, even tomorrow also you can join us. So we can come to learn about many things because we have Pavitra ma'am, who is very sweet and she's very talented also. She used to teach us very well during our sections and all. She used to take every programs in cool, and she used, if we have any doubts also, she used to clear it in that such a sweet manner. And we all understand her way of teaching also. So if you have any opportunities to join in RPA, if our committee, if our RPA committee comes and asks if you can join, please, you can join in our committee also, which is very beneficial for you, not for us. which is very beneficial for you actually. So that's all. I just end of my section now.
And thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you once again, Suganya ma'am, for this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Karnamukhi, for the lively session. So even
you,
I got interested to explore RPA. So definitely everyone would have got the same. Okay, and
thank
we are
you,
demo, so which was very inspiring. And thank you, Da, for the session.
Thank you, ma'am.